All right, so a couple hours ago, Claude Code released their biggest update yet, which is 2.0. And this includes all these updates over here, and we're going to be going over them and talking about what's changed, and also talking a little bit about Claude Sonnet 4.5, which is now their best in the world coding model. And you can see that right over here. But let's focus on Claude Code first. So firstly, if you want to update Claude Code to make sure you're on the latest version, you can run Claude update, and that will then update to the latest version for you. And running Claude, you should see a fresh coat of paint from the whole application. So the design is a little bit different from before. I do like the little droid figure that they have. And of course, if you run slash model, then you can see that Sonnet 4.5 is now the smartest model and used for daily use. But because of the way that I've set up my terminal and theme, you can't see the new background color, but you may be able to on other devices. Anyways, a pretty big change it added is this new rewind command. So you can go back to any point in the conversation history where any changes may have happened. So it's like making checkpoints throughout the conversation history as you're making changes. So for example, over here, I got it to make some changes to colors throughout the application. And if I do slash rewind, and you can see I can go back just before I enter that command, change the landing page colors of the Next.js application. So I think a checkpoint is basically made throughout the code base whenever you give it a command, and those are like the checkpoints. So you can see this is current, this is rewind where there would be no code changes, and this is like when I enter this message. So if I press that, it will ask me if I want to restore the code and conversation, restore just a conversation, or restore the code. So I think this option is like really handy, really nice. It means I probably don't have to use a get as much to like go back and forth between changes when I'm implementing a feature. And it seems more flexible as well because you can go back in terms of conversation history too. You can also do slash usage to see your plan limits, and it takes you to this new tab of settings that shows you your usage for the current session. You can also now use tab to toggle thinking. So if you press tab on your computer, it should turn it off and on. And this will turn on thinking for whichever model that you're using, because Anthropic ship a non-thinking and thinking version of their models. And of course, if you do want to see how the non-thinking and thinking models compare, then you can go on this website over here and it should list out the comparisons and benchmarks for you. You can also now do Ctrl+R to search your entire chat history. So if I do Ctrl+R, then search page, then press tab, it jumps back to like that particular prompt at that particular moment. So I can make a modification to a prompt, and then press enter again. Unfortunately, I have no idea what this unshipped Claude config command is, but for the Claude Code SDK, they now have renamed it to the Claude Agent SDK, probably because a lot of people are using it to do things that weren't coding related, and they just wanted to make that clearer. They also now allow you to add subagents dynamically with a dash dash agents flag. So if you have a file that looks kind of like this, and it's a JSON file, then you can go to your terminal and run Claude dash dash agents, and then reference the JSON file. And that should create both of those agents within Claude Code. And I'm actually not sure if I use that command properly because I don't see the agent, despite it being described as this. So like maybe I'll come back to this when I figure this out. They also now have a brand new native VS Code extension. So if you go to VS Code and then press install, you can see that this should be on version 2.00, 2.00 over here. And after it's installed, then you can press the Claude button in the top right. And it should look kind of like a pretty nice chat. Can you change the color of the website landing page to green? And now it's going to do everything that it does. And you can see it has a bunch of commands if I zoom in a second. Then I can select any of these commands over here when it comes to attaching a file, for example, by doing slash. And then, I don't know, mention. And then choose a file from this drop-down list over here. And this is probably preferred for people who like having more of an interface and being less in the terminal, maybe. But yeah, it's interesting. Yeah, so I'll leave a comment down below once I figure out how to use this particular command. But that was everything to do with Claude Code 2.0. Anyways, moving on to Sonnet 4.5, you can see right over here, it's now the best code like software engineering agent in the world. So it gets a high score on the software engineering benchmark over here. You can see some of the scores over here, and it seems there's about a 3%, 5% jump between Opus 4.1 and Sonnet 4 when it comes to agentic coding in this benchmark. So I'm not sure if that will like be noticeable when you're actually coding day to day, but I will make a follow-up video about it if it actually is. They have their own misaligned behavior scores, and it seems to be their most aligned model. And you can look at the system card as well if you're more interested in all these scores, which is like a super, super long document, which I won't be reading. As I said earlier, they renamed the Claude Code SDK to be the Claude Agent SDK. So you can now basically build agents for any other task quite easily with this SDK. And they also released this new research preview called Imagine with Claude that if you go to, then you can basically come up with some random thing with your Claude code account. So if I press like take me to NYC in the 1980s, let's see what it does. And you can see it's done right over here. I'm not exactly sure what this is used for, but maybe it's pretty cool. And then it makes me this like random thing for NYC. This is a bit naughty. So anyways, let's go back. You can also now track your usage in real time across Claude applications and Claude code by going to settings in Claude.ai. And you can see this is my current usage right over here for my 5-hour block. And this is exactly the same thing that if you do Claude and then slash usage, it is the same amount as you can see over here. Oh, actually it's 1% off. I'm not exactly sure why. That's quite interesting. Maybe it's the way they're rounding it. Something else they also added is context management. And you can see it right over here in a small example, where it's playing a Catalan game, which is like a popular board game. And what happens is that once Claude realizes it doesn't need like a particular thing in its context anymore, then it removes it, as you can see over here. So it crosses it out, and then like the amount of tokens in its context like decreases, and it also removes stale context as well. So I think that's particularly useful when it comes to coding, because there may be a particular like terminal output that happened in Claude code that you no longer need, and that can be removed, and then you don't have to compact the conversation quite as much. There is some documentation about it over here. So it says that when activated, the API automatically clears the oldest two results in chronological order, replacing them with placeholder text to let Claude know that the tool was removed. But doing this context editing invalidates the cached prompt, and because cache tokens are cheaper to account for this, they only recommend clearing enough tokens to make the cache invalidation worthwhile. And they have this parameter over here, so you can ensure a minimum number of tokens is cleared every single time. And then it's supported on these models over here, and they give an example of how to use it that you can read through, use the link down below. Another thing worth noting is that the pricing for Sonnet 4.5 is exactly the same when it comes to input tokens and output tokens as Sonnet 4 was right down over here. And I think the general statement that people are having is that Anthropic don't really care about making their models cheaper, they just care about having the best models overall. But we'll see what happens when Sonnet 5 and Opus 5 come out. Anyways, if you do want to see more Claude code related news in the future, then do subscribe to the channel and like the video, because it lets me know that I should make more of this stuff, and also lets the algorithm know to recommend this to more people. Anyways, if you are interested in improving your vibe coding and vibe marketing skills and learning some advanced techniques that I cover in my community over here, then there will be a link down below. I also teach people how to build profitable web applications and mobile applications, and a bunch of people have had success, as you can see right over here. If you click the link down below, there will be a lot more information, but if you do join, then you get personal help from me for anything that you're stuck with, and I think that's one of the biggest value adds for many people.